commercial fishing, it's completely changed the way that we've fishing, especially people like myself who were brought up with river fishing and open-ended fishing for skimmers and bream, where we used to use 12 and 13 foot rods for bream fishing and for fishing on the Trent and chucking a long way. But nowadays it's all changed because we don't have to fish that far. There's nothing worse than using a 12 or 13 foot rod when you've got a 20 yard cast. It's almost impossible. It makes it really hard work. So there's lots of carp rods brought out now, 12 and 13 foot, and they are all right on these big open spanses of water where they've got to cast a long way. Most commercial lakes, you're chucking up to 30 yard. You don't need these kind of rods. So what we've developed is a mini range series. And what we've done basically, we've got a 10 foot carp rod, a 10 foot carp rod, and all we've done, we've got like a 12 foot carp rod, converted it into 10 foot. People think, oh, 10 foot, is it a little bond or a little winkle picker or something like that? It's a 10 foot carp rod. It's made for carp fishing. It makes life easy. It makes, when you go fishing, a lot more simpler. What I mean by that is, it's easier to cast up to 30 yard with a 10 foot rod than it is a 12 foot rod. But there's a couple other points about it. First of all, the action. The action is a nice through action. It's not too stiff, it's not too soft, which is what you're really looking for. The tip is a medium tip. I see a lot of carp anglers and what they're doing, the tip are too strong. You don't need that, it's just a red tip that's a medium action, so you get some bend through the rod. A lot of people use rods that are too stiff for carp fishing. You want a medium action, but the action needs to be all the way through the rod. And all it is, a 10 foot cast. It makes life a lot easier for casting shorter distances. But the best beauty about it is when you hook a fish, it comes up near the keep net. Because the rod is shorter, when it first comes to the surface, the fish, you can net it easier because it comes close to the bank. When you're using a 12 foot rod and it's further out, you have to play it a little bit longer. It makes a massive difference. One of the other problems people have nowadays is quite simply this, the reel line. You've got to use a modern day line. You've got to use a line that's hard wearing. You're catching a lot of fish, you're playing fish all the time, they're in the keep net, landing net, sorry, bouncing about. You need a modern day line. I still see anglers with 3 and 4 pound line fishing for carp. You don't need to. I use 5 or 6 pound Coram line. If I'm feeder fishing, I use 6 pound. If I'm fishing with the 11 foot splashy wag type waggler, I use 5 pound. And the only difference between the two is that you're in and out with a 5 pound. It's a lot easier to get it in and out quicker. But if I'm feeder fishing, 6 pound Coram reel line. Use a modern day line. And with that setup, you won't really go far wrong. A 10 foot mini series carp rod, 6 pound Coram reel line. You're fishing modern day standards. That's what it's about. It makes life a lot easier. There you go, one on. When you catch a fish, all you do, you put the rod 2 foot off the water and just wind and let the fish swim towards you like so. You can see the nice bend in the rod. When the fish wants to fight, you can see it bending. Just bring it in and let the fish swim towards you. When you get it under your rod tip, you can pick up and look where it is. All I do then, just net it, quite simple, because when the fish comes up, it's come up close to the bank. With a 12 foot rod, it'd be further out and then it'll go back down, you've got to play it. Even though it's a small fish, it came up at 6 foot from the bank where I can get at it quite easily. That's one of the advantages, and it's a massive advantage with a 10 foot rod instead of a 12 foot rod.